just some quarantine content for you as we stay at home and try to be productive. Today I'm actually going to be doing my oil change for the car. I'm going to be using this vacuum extractor, and it's from OEM Tools, something that I got off of eBay or Amazon, I just can't remember. But yeah, I will be using this to extract the oil from the car. And then so I have bought the oil filter, I've bought the two air filters here, and then I also have the liquid moly engine oil. And whenever you're buying for Mercedes-Benz, just make sure it has this MB229.3, just to make sure that it's safe oil for your Mercedes-Benz. And it's obviously fully synthetic, as you can see. So my car takes 8 liters, and that's why we have 5, 6, 7, 8 liters here. And yeah, without wasting much time, let's quickly open this up and quickly use this vacuum extract, and then I'll show you how it works. So first things first, just take off these two here. You just pull it off like this, and it should come up just like that. Very simple. Let's put it there. And then the second thing that we want to take off is this. So you just pull this inward like this. These are the inlet pipes, like that. And then this one also, just pull it off. Okay, put this aside. And then there's this tag here, this tag that holds this down. You can push it backwards just like that, and then this one should be able to come off slowly if you wiggle it. And yeah, there it comes. So the air filters are in here. So we have two air filters, one day, that's why we have two air filters. And then this is the oil filter that we are going to be opening. When you want to extract the oil from the engine, you just take out your dip slide and then just wipe off this oil so that it doesn't mess the engine up. And then you can put it somewhere here, and then take your vacuum extractor. It's connected like this. It comes with two fronts, but the smallest one is the one that's meant for the dip slide testing. Make sure it's fully connected and it's airtight. So, and then you just stick it in there, in the dip slide place here, and then until, make sure you slide it in until it touches the ground. So all the way down until it can't go anymore, just like that. Okay, so just make sure this cap here is inserted, because if it's not, you get air pressure loss from your vacuum tube. So after a few pumps, just like 15 push pumps here, and then you will see your oil starts to come like this, as you can see. And so yeah, that's the oil that's coming from the engine to the vacuum pump. And yeah, let me just pump until, the more you pump, the more vacuum it creates and the harder this handle gets. So it's like a workout, and also, you know, you're doing oil change, which is good, so it's being productive. So in the meantime, as the oil drains into here, it will continuously drain, and then when the vacuum goes lower, you see the volume of oil starts to come with bubbles, and you just pump a little bit to add to the vacuum. And then let me now open the oil filter. This is the oil filter. This is my oil filter removal tool. Use it like this, twist anti-clockwise like that, and then just make sure you have a cloth, because it has a bit of oil that can mess your engine up. And then unscrew it like this, and then yeah, just take it off like that. If we open this oil filter here, we can see that it comes with the rings here, and all you need is basically a flathead screwdriver to take off the old rings. So you just do it like this. So start with the big ring first, just like that, and then we take off the two smaller rings. Okay, so there are the three rings that we took out, and this is the old oil filter. Let me just clean my hand and put on the new rings. Make sure there's no dust. So, the bigger ring. Okay. That is the bigger ring, and then the smaller rings. Okay, so we have our three rings installed, and then you just take the new oil filter and then you just put it in. It has instructions on how to put it, and basically you see that it has these two lines. You should make sure that one of these lines is all the way in, so you should only be able to see one line here, as you can see. So just like this, twist it all the way in, and yeah, so yeah, just twist it all the way in until it reaches the top and you can only see one of these line, and yeah, that means your air filter is tightly in. And then you can now quickly go ahead and install your oil filter. Hand tight is usually good, but since I have the two, let me just twist it a little bit. Yeah, and that should do it. It's not going anyway, so that's it for the oil filter. Now for the air filter, all you need to do is just to remove these four nuts that are on each side of the air filter, and all you need is a T25 tool, and I did that, so just like this. The cameraman helped me out taking out these air filters, and credits to him. Just remove the old air filters just like this. Yeah, the air filters are actually very dirty, as you can see. And yeah, the other one is this one. Okay, so I've cleaned it as much as I can, removed all the dust, and then what you just do is just place your air filters in just like that. I don't know what this thing is. Yeah, just like that. Make sure it's firmly in. It should go in this groove here. Yeah, so yeah, just like that. And the other side too. Yeah, just like that. And then once you're done, you can tighten the four nuts on each side of the air filters, and then you're done, and all you have to do is put this back on the car. So take your T25 and then just tighten these four nuts. Okay, so air filters have been placed in and it's all locked. So I have these four stuff that I need to align here, and then the back clips on, so just make sure they are aligned, and then you press it down. So yep, this is the line. Yeah, just like that. And then bring this clip back on to clip here. Okay, so once this is on, make sure you put this inlet pipe here that comes from the engine to the air filter compartment in. It has arrows that align here, so just make sure you put that in tight. And then once it's in, just like that, you can go ahead and put this on. It aligns here, so this aligns with there, and this clips in there, and the other one clips in here. So okay, and then this is on now, so let's put these intake pipes. It should just be tightly on, and the other side too. Okay, yeah, just like that. And yeah, let's drain the rest of the oil, as you can see, and then we'll put new oil in. Okay, so my container vacuum breaker is full now, 8 liters out. And so yeah, let's remove this
pipe out. Yeah, once you remove the pipe, you can lay it somewhere. We'll clean it up later. And then just to verify that there's nothing left in the engine, we can use this, just put this in and then, you know, when you bring out the dipstick, it should be clear, just like that. So you see it has nothing. Put it in just to verify, we put it in a second time. And just to verify, you see that it's clear and it actually has nothing. We have no oil in the engine. Now, let's go ahead and pour in our oil into the car. This is the liquid moly 0W40. This is what Mercedes-Benz recommends. And it has the MB229.3 rating. So, let's put this in. Now, unfortunately, I couldn't find my funnel, so I went ahead and made a custom funnel. This is from, I think, an olive oil container that I cleaned, and I'm going to be using this as my funnel. So now let's quickly go ahead and pour in the oil. Okay, so we've put in about 5, 6, 7 liters into the car now. And so for this last liter, we're going to run the engine so that the oil filter that's there takes up some of the oil, and then we'll be able to tell how our oil level is. And then once we are able to tell that, we'll be able to tell how much of this last liter we need to put in, whether we need to put it in all at once or whether we need to put in just a section of it. So that's how you do it. And then once you determine the how much level you need to top up, all you need to do is pull this cap here, and then you can go ahead and pour out this dirty oil and put it in here. And then once you're done, you can always go and recycle that. And so basically that's how you do it. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button down below and then hit subscribe and turn on bell notifications so that you get the latest videos as soon as we release them. And thank you very much, and we'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.